Good morning, family. Come on in. Hear my voice? Now is the beckoning call. We would love to worship with you. Today will be a little bit different in here, so we're going to have to maybe move a little scrunch together. We got, I think it's 36 ladies are worshiping on that mountain right there, the Santa Cruz Mountains, and just receiving from the Lord. So it's going to be a great day for them and a great day for us. We've got just wonderful missionaries. We're going to tell you about what God is doing in their lives. But most importantly, family, God's here. He's never left us. And so I just want to welcome you here. My name is Sean. I'm the worship pastor here at Abundant Life. For those of you online, live stream, it's good to see you. We'd love to have you here if you can make it. But otherwise, we're glad that you're able to see us that means. But as you come and you find your spot, if you'd stand with us, we're going to worship the Lord together in song and rejoice unto him. All that means is we have an opportunity right now just to remind ourselves that he's with us and how he loves us. Give ourselves an opportunity to thank him. But before we do, I'm just going to pray for us. Heavenly Father, I thank you that right now in this place, God, that we can lay all of our burdens down before you. That we can remind ourselves, God, that you are the giver of life. We don't have to worry in your presence as we stay connected with you, Lord. And as we follow you, we don't have to fear. We can walk through that valley. God, may you be glorified in our worship in this time today. And it's in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said,
amen. Amen.
Because he changed my heart, he changed my name, forever free.
Good morning, church. If you don't know me, my name is Chanson, and I just want to welcome all the new guests with us here today. If you're looking for a church that is perfect, that's not us, but we are a church that wants to grow together and heal together. And so if you're looking for that, you found the right place. And so if you're a new guest, we have a gift for you at the Welcome Center in the front of the church, just to get you connected and some more information. The first thing on our church calendar coming up is Pastor Appreciation, and that's going to be October 6th, and it's just a time where we get to appreciate our pastors. They do so much for us. They sacrifice so much for us, and we want to appreciate them. And so we're going to do two things on October 6th. We'll have a table on the patio, not this Sunday, but next Sunday, to write notes, cards, to each of the pastors, and then also a lunch after church, just on the field, just to connect, hang out. And that's it for October 6th. October 26th, not to get confused with the 6th, we're going to have Candyland, which is our once a year fun fest where we have thousands of people come in, and we just get an opportunity to spread the love to these kids and these families. And so, like I said, there's a lot of people that come to this event. And so if you're able to help out, volunteer, or want more information before committing, we're going to have a table outside this Sunday and the next coming Sundays, just to sign up and volunteer for that. And that's all I have for you guys today. So let's continue to praise Jesus.
Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand, when everything around me is shaken. I've never been more glad that I put my faith in Jesus, 'cause he's never let me down. He's faithful through generations, so why would he fail now? He won't. No, he won't. I've still got joy in chaos. I've got peace that makes no sense, so I won't be going under. I'm not held by my own strength, 'cause I built my life on Jesus, and he's never let me down. He's faithful in every season, so why would he fail?
Oh, no, he won't.
you're in that trial, you've got to push through. I promise you, I can say with all certainty, God is true. He won't fail. When rain came, wind blew, my house was built on you. I'm safe with you, and I'm gonna make it through. We sing rain.
God, I pray that would be our heart's cry this morning.
To you all, just felt that this is a good thing for us all to be thinking of. This is in a paraphrase of Romans 12:2, Eugene Peterson in The Message. So here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for Him. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out, readily recognize He wants what He wants from you, and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings the best out of you, develops well-formed maturity in you. Satan doesn't want that for you at all. His aim is to distract you to the point where a phrase that you'll constantly utter is, I don't have time to pray. I don't have time to seek the Lord. That delights the heart of Satan because he's done what he's come to do. Take you from your only source, so that now it's all about you. And that's, you have to depend on yourself. God is here to say, come to me, all your weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, for it's easy, it's light. Family, I just pray as we continue to worship, as we continue to seek him today, that we would remind ourselves, we have to be hearing from him. It can't just be a rule set. It can't just be a way of life. See, that's what the Pharisees did. That was their whole deal. We can't be that today. He wants a relationship with us, and it starts on our knees. It starts in connection. You'll find coincidences will happen often, a lot more to someone who prays.
When I was lost and all alone. You're constant, I've witnessed it, and I'm confident I'll see it again and again. You love and I've witnessed it. You heal and I've witnessed it. You save and I've witnessed it, and I'm confident I'll see it again and again. You're good and I've witnessed it. You're strong and I've witnessed it. You're constant, I've witnessed it, and I'm confident I'll see it again and again. You love and I've witnessed it. You heal and I've witnessed it. You save and I've witnessed it, and I'm confident I'll see it again and again. I've witnessed your faithfulness. I've seen you breathe life within. So I'll pour out my praise again. You're worthy, God, you're worthy of all of this. Your promise is never fair. Not just stories I've lived to tell. So I'll pour out my praise again. You're worthy, God, you're worthy of all of this. To the broken, I've witnessed it. To the hurting, I've witnessed it. To the lost, I will witness it. And I'll tell them it. I'll tell them what I've witnessed. To my family, I've witnessed it. To my city, I've witnessed it. To the nations, I've witnessed it. And I'll tell them it. I'll tell them what I've witnessed. I'll tell them what I've witnessed. Your stories are so worthy.
God, you are worthy of all this. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus, in this place. God, we have witnessed your greatness. We have witnessed your faithfulness. We have witnessed your love. God, forgive us for the times that we forget. We so easily forget all that you've done in our lives. You are faithful and true. And oftentimes, God, we look to other needs, we look to other sources. But when we look to you, you are always enough. You are always faithful. Your ways are higher, Father, than our ways. And so, Father, we look to you now as a church body. I pray, Father, that our collective hearts would say, God, how can we glorify you this day? in this sanctuary, Lord, as we, when the service finishes and we move outside these four walls, God, how can we glorify you today? How can we send your kingdom into the marketplace, into our workplace? Because, family, where you step, the kingdom of God steps. You walk into that grocery store, the kingdom of God has entered that grocery store. Father, I pray we would live with the full confidence that you are always enough. You are faithful and true. Mighty God, be glorified today. It's in Jesus' mighty name that we praise you.